Today we're looking at a really interesting amp. It's called the Berkshire Grape Ape. It's by my friend Jamie Hebert. And the really interesting thing about this amp is it's got four KT88s for power, but they're split up into pairs. So each of those pairs has their own output transformer, their own output jack. Hence, you have to have both those speaker jacks loaded. Or he provides you with a Y cable kind of thing so you can plug them into one speaker. The reason he does that is he's trying to get the most out of this amp and make it sound the most like sort of an old twin meets sort of a 60s Marshall with its own sort of vibe. And it's very easy to use. It's got a full power and half power switch, and I'll show you that in a minute. The interesting thing is the half power switch really works on this. Some amps, you turn a half power switch on and you don't really hear that much difference. You know what I mean? With this one, it does cut the power down quite a bit. And I think it's probably because each of those single tubes are on their own power transformers. Now, it has a master volume, which you can see. It has a reverb, which sounds stellar. I'll show you that right now. Beautiful clean sound. It's got bass, obviously. It's got a mid control that has a pull boost, which we're gonna show you all about that in a minute. It's got a treble, obviously, and then it's got a pull bright switch on the volume control for the main volume of the amp. Right now, I've got it set sort of what I think is for an optimum clean sound with humbuckers, which I've got the master about 3/4 up, the reverb barely on, just to give you a little taste. Bass about 10 o'clock, mid-range about 11 o'clock, treble maybe 2 o'clock, and the volume on about 10 o'clock with the bright switch pulled out so it is in the bright mode, which you'll hear. It's a lot of sustain.
I think that's an amazing. Yeah. Amplifier.
A lot of clean sustain. Now, here's what's fun about it. It comes with a foot switch. I'm not showing you what the foot switch does. I'm going to show you from the front panel because you can do both things. So I'm going to lean over here for just a minute. Excuse me. And I'm going to do this. I'm going to pull the boost out for the mid, push the bright in, turn that volume up just a little bit, turn the reverb down just a touch, and then you get this, which is kind of a very, very Warren Haynes sort of thing, which is what Jamie was like sort of inspired by for this amp. And what I want to do now is I'm going to show you something. You're going to put that half power switch on, turn the master down just a little bit, turn your mid-range up, volume up, and you get even more. Watch. And the verb works really well. You can actually put a little more verb on there, a little more of the master volume up, and you get even more fun. Watch. Fun, right?
Wow.
Isn't that great?
Now you can also turn the master down quite a bit and still get a good tone. Watch. Now, and the cool thing about this too is that it's got a handmade chassis. He uses Mercury Magnetics custom transformers, Telefunken tubes. Everything is hand wired, right? So the guy spared no expense on this amp. And one thing I really like about it is it's a little old school. The power cable even is attached like an old amp, like a 60s amp. And my friend Eric Johnson says there's something to that. Tonally, like the old amps that have the power cables that are unattachable, that are just there. There's something to that. I mean, and I'm hearing some really cool vintage tones here, some things that you really can't fake any other way. And then, of course, you're going to always ask me, you know, what guitar is that? It's a Valerie Vashenko Les Paul. Valerie Vashenko Les Paul.
That is gorgeous.
Yeah, and I want to show you. It works really well with pedals. Some amps that sound like this don't take pedals well. So I want to set it up clean again for you, right? I want to turn the master up a little bit. Okay. So I'm going to turn on my Lee Jackson Fuzzy Finger 2, okay? So here's the amp. It's called the Grape Ape, by the way, this amp. Takes pedals. Now I want to show you the exciting analog design Octavia with it. Octavias will kind of screw up completely if the amp's not really tuned in. So much. Sexy. And then just a regular sort of gain boost pedal in front now, watch. And now let's get the gain back up on the amp a little bit, pull that mid boost back out, which is foot switchable. When you think it was safe to go outside, I'd like to show you this amp now with a single coil pickup, okay?
Yep.
So give me 1 second. Be right back. And we're back. Okay, I've got my trusty Charles Whitfield Tele here, which is kind of the best Telecaster I've ever had. And I'll show you the clean sounds of this. Now I'm going to turn the high power mode back up, give it a little bit more headroom, and you got this. Some of you are going to go, yeah, but what does it sound like gained up on its own without any pedals with a single coil? I'm going to show you that. So we'll step back over here. We're going to pull that gain knob, then crank the gain up a little bit, and you got this. Watch. Now I'm going to turn the fuzz on and go all the way. Got it. So look, guys, the Berkshire amplification amp, he's got several models. This is kind of the most out there one, based on the fact that it has two output transformers. It kind of reminds me of the Warren Haynes sort of tone he gets out of his Diaz amp. And it's a rare tone. It's very cool. And it's very flexible. So if a guy wants to set this up on the edge of breakup and then use some gain pedals in front and then use that foot switch to kick the mid boost in on this, you're there. It's a great sounding amp. And I think at the half power mode and use the master volume, you can get away with a lot in a small room and not really piss a lot of people off, yet it's got enough headroom to be on stage with a band that's as loud as like the Allman Brothers. So,
yeah, man.
Berkshire, we're going to put all the contact information right here. Let him know we sent you. And I'm, once again, Lance, and you are still Kurt.
I still am.
Yes. And so this has been the Berkshire Amplification Grape Ape, the Grape Ape. So get it from them. It's a great sounding amp. And I am out. See ya.
All right. Thank you.